The U.S. has the second largest cultivated land of any country at 1.68 million square kilometers, compared with 1.24 million square kilometers in China. 18% of U.S. land is cultivated land. Wheat, corn, and soybeans are the major crops grown in the U.S. Much of these crops feed not only Americans, but also other parts of the world. As a result, the U.S. is a net exporter of food. Whereas, only 13% of China's total land area can be cultivated. China fed 18.2% of the world's population with only 6.7% of the world's arable land. China's arable land is primarily in the eastern region, also the most densely populated region of the country. In addition to extensive areas of western China, which are relatively uninhabited, substantial portions of southern China are unfavorable for agriculture because of mountainous topography. Today, China is the largest importer of agricultural products in the world. In terms of cultivated land, U.S. dominates. Precipitation, especially rain, has a dramatic effect on agriculture. This is because all plants need at least some water to survive. Therefore, rain is essential to agriculture. The eastern of U.S., with annual average precipitation of 40 inches, has been dominated in corn and soybean production. While the western, drier half is known as the wheat belt for its high rate of wheat production. The Central Valley of California, precipitation range from 20 inches to 5 inches a year, produces fruits, vegetables, and nuts. One-third of the United States has an annual precipitation of less than 20 inches, and one-eighth of less than 10 inches. China can roughly be divided into four different agroclimatic zones. The desert areas in the west, mountain ranges including Tibet and Inner Mongolia. This is a vast area, and since precipitation is below 8 inches, and average temperatures range between minus 4 and 12 degrees Celsius, it is dominated by grassland and used for animal husbandry. The northeastern region close to Beijing is relatively flat, and its climatic conditions, rainfall, between 23 to 39 inches, average temperature between 2 to 14 degrees Celsius, favor wheat, corn, and soybean production. The subtropical regions of the south are characterized by more than 39 inches of rainfall and annual average temperatures above 14 degrees Celsius. Here, rice, tea plantations, and most of the forests can be found. Further to the southeast and towards the coast, precipitation may reach 79 inches and temperatures average 18 to 24 degrees Celsius. Under such tropical conditions, 2 to even 3 harvests can be realized and also sugar cane is planted in a small area. One-third of China's land has annual precipitation below 16 inches. A quarter is less than 8 inches. The conclusion is U.S. dominant in terms of precipitation, as its rainfall is more suitable for agriculture. China's total area is 9.6 million square kilometers, which accounted for about 6% of the world's total land area. Among the land resources, about one-third are mountains, approximate 26% are plateau, 19% are basins, 9% are hills, and only about 12% are plains. The eastern plains and southern coasts of the country consist of fertile lowlands and foothills. They are the location of most of China's agricultural output and human population. The west and north of the country are dominated by sunken basins, such as the Gobi Desert and the Taklamakan Desert, rolling plateaus and towering massifs. It contains part of the highest tableland on Earth, the Tibetan Plateau, and has much lower agricultural potential and population. U.S. total land area is 9.1 million square kilometers, slightly smaller than China. The eastern regions consist of hills and low mountains, while the central interior is a vast plain called the Great Plains region, which accounted for about one-third of the United States. The west has high rugged mountain ranges, some of which are volcanic in the Pacific Northwest. Alaska also features rugged mountains as well as river valleys. Hawaii's landscape varies but is dominated by volcanic topography. U.S. plain area is about 3 times larger than China. The larger plain area means the construction cost for the road, infrastructure, and building will be reduced. It will also facilitate large-scale mechanized planting and benefit economic development. Thus, the U.S. dominates in terms of terrain. The United States is surrounded by the sea on 3 sides. It borders the Atlantic Ocean on the east and the Pacific Ocean on the west. Alaska faces the Arctic Ocean. The total length of U.S. coastline is 19,924 kilometers. The Atlantic and Pacific coasts are also the most densely distributed areas of large cities in the United States. Mainland China is flanked to the east and south by the Yellow, East China, and South China Seas, which are marginal seas of the Pacific Ocean. China's mainland coastline measures approximately 18,000 kilometers. Most of the coastline is densely covered with ports. It is also the most densely distributed area of large cities in China. The U.S. is dominant in terms of the estuary. The United States has three medium-sized islands, namely Hawaii, Kodiak, Puerto Rico, and several small islands. A total of more than 5,000 islands dot China's territorial waters. The largest of these, with an area of about 36,000 square kilometers, is Taiwan, followed by Hainan, with an area of 34,000 square kilometers. China's islands are dominant in terms of area, whereas the United States is dominant in terms of distribution. China has 2.2 million square kilometers of forest area, with a coverage rate of 23%. U.S.'s forest area is about 3.1 million square kilometers, with a coverage rate of 34%. The U.S. dominates. China has 3.93 million square kilometers of grasslands, 84% is deemed usable for grazing. In fact, China is one of the countries with the richest grassland resources in the world, and it accounted for 40% of the country's total land area. The grasslands of northern China extend from the western edge of Manchuria, across the Inner Mongolia steppe and lowest plateau of Shaanxi and Gansu provinces to the Tibet-Qinghai plateau and the mountains and basins of Central Asia. In the United States, only 5% of the original grasslands remain, or about 1.45 million square kilometers. All national grasslands of the U.S. are located on or at the edge of the Great Plains except for three in central Oregon, northeastern California, and southeastern Idaho. Thus, China dominates in terms of grasslands. The sheer size and geographic diversity of the United States mean that the country experiences various natural disasters frequently. The United States is extremely vulnerable to natural disasters. Every state is exposed to one or more of a host of hazards, floods, hurricanes, severe storms, snow, and wildfires. In the last few decades, almost all types of major hazards except volcanic eruptions have hit China. These include earthquakes, typhoons, floods, droughts and sandstorms, storm surges, pests and rodent disease, and forest and grassland fires. U.S. and China ties in terms of natural disasters. China has 55 World Heritage Sites to date. Of these, 37 are cultural heritage sites, 14 are natural heritage sites, and 4 are cultural and natural mixed sites, ranking first in the world. There are 24 World Heritage Sites in the United States, including 12 natural heritage sites, 1 cultural and natural mixed sites, and 11 cultural heritage sites. Obviously, China has an advantage in cultural heritage, and land exchange will cause huge losses. China has one of the most enormous numbers of bird species in the world, 1,244, to be exact. Giant pandas, South China tigers, and Tibetan antelopes are a few of the 667 endemic vertebrate species. In total, 581 mammal species, 376 reptile species, and 284 amphibians help bring megadiversity to China. In addition, half of the 30,000 plants found in this country are also endemic to the area. The U.S. has about 432 mammal species, 800 bird species, 311 reptile species, and 295 amphibian species. In addition, there are several endemic animals, including the Channel Islands spotted skunk, and on the island of Hawaii, nearly 90% of the wildlife are endemic. There are also more than 17,000 species of plants spread throughout the country. China's biodiversity is dominant. China holds 25 trillion barrels of proven oil reserves, ranking 13th in the world and accounting for about 1.4% of the world's total oil reserves. Whereas, the U.S. holds 47 trillion barrels of proven oil reserves, ranking 10th in the world. China is one of the leading mining countries in the world. They are top producer in phosphates, vanadium, tungsten, antimony, graphite, coal, tin, molybdenum, lead, zinc, and gold. Also, they are the second top producers of manganese, bauxite, cobalt, silver, and copper. 90% of the natural resources in the state include rare earth metals and coal. Other critical natural commodities in China include timber, chromium, and gem diamond. The total natural resources in China are estimated to be worth over $23 trillion. Mining is one of the primary industries in the United States. The United States has been known as the leading producers of coal for decades now, and currently, they control over 31% of the global coal reserves and a significant amount of timber. The total natural resources in the country are valued at $45 trillion, with over 89% of them being timber and coal. The United States has a sizable deposit of copper, gold, oil, and natural gas. U.S. dominant in terms of natural resources. China is closely surrounded by a large number of other countries. On land, China shares borders with 14 states. The most important of these are North Korea, Vietnam, Myanmar, India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Mongolia, Laos, Bhutan, Nepal, Russia, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Kazakhstan. At sea, Chinese territorial claims abut or overlap with some of the same states and six others, including South Korea, Japan, the Philippines, Brunei, Malaysia, and Indonesia. China has had border disputes with many of these countries, leading to military clashes with some of the neighboring countries. The United States borders Canada in the north and Mexico in the south. Canada and the United States share the longest border between two countries. In addition to its land border, the United States has a maritime border shared with Russia, Cuba, and the Bahamas. The delineation of the United States borders was achieved through numerous treaties that the country signed throughout its history. In terms of neighboring countries, the U.S. dominant. The exchange of land will cause China to lose a considerable amount of cultural heritage, biodiversity, grassland, and island area advantages. No loss in most other areas. The overall benefits outweigh the disadvantages.